News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the words and phrases you need to talk about the news. Hi, I'm Neil and joining me today is Sian. Hi, Sian.
Hi.
What is today's story?
Okay, so we know that boxing legend Muhammad Ali died recently. We have a story about the preparations which are taking place for his funeral this week.
Right, so boxing legend Muhammad Ali's funeral, what are the preparations and who's going to be there? Let's find out from this BBC World Service news bulletin.
It's been announced that the Hollywood star Will Smith and the former world heavyweight boxing champion Lennox Lewis will be pallbearers at Muhammad Ali's funeral. Smith played Ali in the 2001 movie of the same name, earning an Oscar nomination and becoming a family friend.
Okay, so the story tells us that ex-boxer Lennox Lewis and actor Will Smith will be carrying Muhammad Ali's coffin at his funeral this week. And Will Smith became friends with Muhammad Ali after he played Muhammad in a film about his life.
All right. Well, you've been looking online at how this story is being covered, haven't you, Sian?
Mm-hmm.
And what are the three words and expressions that are useful for understanding and talking about this story?
Okay, so I've picked out three words. The first word is memorial. The second is pallbearer. And the third is biopic.
Okay, so some definitions. A memorial, that's an event to honour or remember a person who has died. A pallbearer, someone who carries a coffin at a funeral. And a biopic is a film about the life of a real person. So how are these words and expressions appearing in the headlines and articles you've seen?
Okay, so the first headline I have is from E! News, and it says, details of Muhammad Ali's public memorial announced. Okay, so we see the word memorial here.
Yeah, and that's a service? Is it just a service?
So it's a service to remember somebody who has died, but it doesn't have to be a service. We can also have an object. So you can have a memorial bench in a park or a memorial statue to remember somebody who has died.
Yeah, in town centres you can see sometimes a big piece of stone with names.
So that's called a war memorial. So to remember people who've died in a war.
Yes, and in Hyde Park in London, there's a fountain, a memorial fountain for Princess Diana.
Yes, there is. Yes, exactly. So the word's quite interesting because it comes from memory. So the root is memory. And there are lots of words from memory. So we have remember, memorize, memorable. The pronunciation's quite interesting because memory, we have the stress on the first syllable.
Memory.
And then memorial, the stress moves to the second syllable.
Memorial.
Exactly.
Yeah. And there's a word connected to this with a spelling change, isn't there? A lot of native English speakers get this wrong. Remembrance.
Yes, so a lot of native speakers remove the add an extra E.
Yeah.
So there's three E's in remember, but the third E disappears. Remembrance.
That's right. Okay, let's have a look at your next word.
Okay, so the next word was pallbearer. And from people.com, we have this headline. Will Smith will be a pallbearer at Muhammad Ali's memorial service.
Yeah, pallbearer, that's a pretty unusual and specific word, isn't it?
So it only really occurs in the context of funerals.
Yeah.
So a pallbearer is a person who carries the coffin.
But the second part of that word, bearer.
So bearer comes from the verb to bear. And there are lots of meanings of this verb. But here and in many cases, it means to carry or to transport something.
Yeah.
Like they transport the coffin.
Yes. Quite a formal word, though, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you could say that somebody came to your house bearing gifts, but it is quite formal.
Yes.
Oh, it could be non-literal. You could say somebody is the bearer of bad news. So somebody who brings you bad news.
Okay. We've got one more word to look at.
Okay, so the third word we have in this story. So from The Telegraph, Will Smith, the actor who played the lead role in the biopic Ali, has been named among the pallbearers to carry Muhammad.
Yeah, so a biopic, a film about a person's life. For example, The Iron Lady about Margaret Thatcher.
Yes, exactly.
The Queen about
the Queen. Yeah.
Yes. But this word is, again, made up of two parts. Mm. Bio.
Yeah, so bio refers to life or living things. So at school, you study the science biology, so the study of living things. If you write a book about somebody's life, we call that a biography.
Yeah. Mm. What's the pic in biopic?
Yeah, so pic is the part that refers to movie. So pic, short for picture, means film or a movie. It's another way of talking about the film. So, for example, if you say, I'm going to the pictures, it means I'm going to the cinema.
Kind of old-fashioned.
Very old-fashioned, yes, exactly.
Okay, well, let's find out a little bit more about this story with this report from the BBC's Adi Adedoyin.
That procession will start around 9 a.m. local time. The hearse will pass through the main streets of Louisville, down an avenue that bears his name, through the neighborhood he grew up, and also down Broadway, where the parade was held to honor him when he won gold in the 1960 Olympic Games in Rome.
The BBC's Adi Adedoyin there, and he used that word that we discussed, to bear. He said that the funeral procession will go down an avenue that bears Muhammad Ali's name. It means carries his name. Okay, it's our Facebook challenge. We set a question for our followers on Facebook connected to one of the words we've looked at today. Here's the question. If you write a book about someone's life, it's called a biography. If you write a book about your own life, it's called a selfie book, B, a self-biography, or C, an autobiography. Only one right answer. Mm. Who got it right and who got it wrong?
Well, not many people said a selfie book. So a selfie is a photo you take of yourself. Although Pilar does make a good point. She says maybe a selfie book is a book full of selfies.
Very good point.
Could be possible. Yep. But the correct answer was an autobiography. So as a few people pointed out, auto coming from the Greek word that means self. So the correct answer was C, autobiography.
Okay, well done to everyone who got that right. Sian, before we go, can you just give us a summary of the words we've looked at today?
Okay, so the words were memorial, an event to honour or remember somebody who has died, and that could also be an object. A pallbearer, somebody who carries a coffin at a funeral. And biopic, the life or the film about the life of a real person.
Thank you very much, and thank you for joining us. Do join us again. And for more help with your English study, go to bbclearningenglish.com. Goodbye.
Bye.
News review from BBC Learning English.